Hello, have a very nice and warm morning to one and all present over here. I'm Professor Mubin Sheikh, welcome you all on the behalf of this auspicious occasion of National Level Board Week organized by our Sri Sai Baba College Shirdi. And we are indeed privileged, honored, blessed and fortunate to have a legendary and a great personality in the field of bird diversity and conservation. Principal Dr. Sudhakarji Muralidhar Kurade, sir. I welcome you, sir, to this extraordinary webinar, which will hopefully turn out to be beneficial and advantageous to many of our students and teachers as well. So hello, galaxy of intellectuals, invited guest, principal of our college, Professor Vikasji Shivagaje, sir, respected teachers and all students, I once again welcome you all on the behalf of Science Association and Zoology Department. And I request to honorable principal of our college, Vikasji Shivagaje, sir, to enact as a chief of this program. And now I would like to call upon our head of Department of Zoology to express his preface talk to convey you all the objectives and importance of this activity.
Good morning, all of you. On the behalf of Department of Zoology, I welcome you all in this program. This program is organized to create awareness and protection of biodiversity. A bird is a very important component of ecosystem. Bird diversity is in great danger worldwide, and many of the birds are coming under rare category because loss of habitat and urbanization. In India, major work on birds was done by the ornithologist and great naturalist Dr. Salim Ali. And in Maharashtra, Sri Maruti Chidampalli also have done lots of work on birds. The birth anniversary of both these legends are in November month, and for that part of celebration, Government of Maharashtra and Forest Department appealed to celebrate Bird Week during 5 to 12 November. Our college and Department of Zoology took this initiative to make this proposal into reality. Now, I'll carry forward to anchor. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. And now I would like to call upon Professor Nitin Pause, sir, to give his inaugural talk.
Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what are you doing, you will be successful. Very good morning to one and all. Everyone who's present over here. I take this privilege to warmly welcome our chief guest, Honorable Dr. Sudhakarji Kurade, Principal Marutrauji Ghule Patil, College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Ahmednagar. I also heartily welcome respected principal of our college, Vikasji Shivagaje, sir, and welcome to all our delegates and students on the occasion of one day Zoom online seminar on birds conservation awareness. This seminar is organized by Science Association in collaboration with Department of Zoology. I wish the one day Zoom online seminar be successful and reach its goals and objectives as mentioned. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. Now it is the moment for all which are waiting for. Okay, so now I feel immense pleasure and privilege, honor to get you introduced about today's guest, Commerce and Science College, Shevgaon, District Ahmednagar. Currently, he is serving as a principal of Marutrauji Ghule Patil College of Arts, Commerce and Science College, Ahmednagar. His research work is incredible, as he published 75 research papers and 225 popular articles on nature, bird watching, wildlife conservation and tourism. These articles got published in leading Marathi and English newspapers. Besides this, he has been authored 7 published books, Besides academics, he also authored several Marathi poetry books like Yatra, Aswad. His other nature related books are Apli Srishti, Ani Pakshi, Nisarga Gaan. He also wrote textbooks for BSc Zoology students. Even being traditional and simple in living, he is much ahead of the time and he is very techno savvy. And he prepared CDs on boards of Ahmednagar and documentary film on Nandur Madhameshwar Nisarga Gatha. He also has a couple of memberships in BNHS, Bombay Natural History Society, Mumbai, India, and Bird Conservation Network, Mumbai. He has several honors at his disposal. First prize in state level open wildlife photo contest and honorary wildlife warden of Ahmednagar district. List is actually unending. And sir, it is really not possible for me to complete all his introduction within such a small span of time, but I tried at my level best. He also has visited 28 wildlife sanctuaries and national parks. So such, I will keep on counting his achievements on and on and on. But we are running out of time. So now his talk, his speech will give you the real introduction by itself. So I would like to call upon Dr. Khurade sir to please bless us with your valuable guidance. Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, yes. Clearly.
Hello?
Yes, go on, sir.
Yeah. So very good morning, all of you. I'm thankful to Principal Sai Baba College Shirdi, the organizer of this webinar, Mubin sir, his colleague, and other staff members. I'm again thankful to Mubin sir for introducing me briefly in so nice words. As Bhand sir pointed out that this week, that is from today, next 7 days, government of Maharashtra has declared this week as a Pakshi Saptah, a week for birds. And as a birder, as an ornithologist, I am proud that Maharashtra is the first state in India to observe, to celebrate such a kind of week, all for only for the birds. And with this context, I have selected this topic, Maitri Pakshanshi, and in this 30 minutes time, I will try to talk about four types of threats the birds they are facing, four conservation measures are there. But before we are going into studying threats and conservation, one should know what is bird exactly, and then how we can identify the bird, where one should go for bird observation, and four different types of birds are there in and around our own area. So it is not so that everyone should go to Kewaldev Ghan or Bharatpur National Park to observe the birds. No. We can just start peeping out from the window of your house, even your classroom, and you can look for number of these beautiful creatures around your college, from your college campus, or from your society, housing society, or from your farmhouse. So, as all of us we know, being science student, bird is a feathered biped. It's a vertebrate animal, warm-blooded animal, and to maintain its body temperature constant in between 30 to 44 degrees Celsius, the entire body is covered with feathers, and all these feathers are non-conducting in nature, which protect the bird from the extreme cold or extreme hot. And so, also, there are many more birds which are seen breeding in very hot summer in Maharashtra or even in Ahmednagar. And this study of bird scientifically is known as ornithology. So if we have to define this term ornithology, then it is a branch of zoology which deals with study of birds. And when we talk that we have to study bird, then what we need, what we look for is about its classification, systematic, that is taxonomy, then from which group birds are evolved, known as paleontology, and how the birds, they behave, that is ethology. And of course, the birds where they are living is the avian ecology. So this is not today's science. Even the ancient literature of all religion, they reports number of animals and number of birds. To name few, it is in Rig Veda, 20 birds are reported, in Yajur Veda, 60 birds are reported, and in Athar Veda, number of raptors are reported. The latter literature like Upanishada, Valmiki Ramayana, Mahabharat, we are known with Jatayu. Jatayu was also a type of bird from those days. So all these scientific all these ancient writings, they report number of birds from those areas. It is a fact we proudly share with all is India is one of the mega biodiversities in the world. And there is reason why India is one of the mega diversity in the world, that in spite of very small, very mere geographic area, we contribute a lot, about 8 to 10% in the total biodiversity of the world. And that's why India, it ranks at 12th. Secondly, we have many more areas which are recognized as hotspots of biodiversity. So these hotspots of biodiversity, they indicate that the flora and fauna from these areas is no more found in other part of India or other part of world. That means all this flora and fauna is endemic to our area. And this endemism, it values more in biodiversity. And that's why we say India is one of the mega diversities of the world. Now coming to the threats to the bird, here I am talking only about the bird, not all about flora and fauna. So what threats the birds are posing? The first important is the climate change. Now when we talk about climate change, there is a huge literature on climate change. So,
hello sir.
Everyone knows this term, and we witness that climatic changes are taking place.
Hello, one
now
minute,
what relation of climate change is there with birds?
Hello,
I told you,
sir.
The ecology or habitat in which bird live, it is most important. If the climate change is going to alter the habitat,
reshare your screen. Reshare your screen. Can you please reshare your screen? Screen PPT. PPT share kara sir.
Hello.
Can you please share your screen?
Hello. Can you see this slide, sir?
No, no. Can you please reshare? Reshare.
Okay. Just wait. Can you see the first slide? Hello?
No, sir, not it.
We'll just share it once again.
Started. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now it is opened.
Now it is opened. Okay. So, this climate change, it is all over the world. It is not so that only we Indians were suffering from the climate change, but climate change is observed all over the world, and it is the flora and fauna that is suffering. And birds, it is the one of the unit which suffers a lot because of this. I have told you that because of climate change, the breeding season is altered, and being this is the migratory season, because of climate change, ornithologists are worried that whether it could alter the migratory time of bird or not, and the studies are going on. So when we talk about migration, there are many birds which visit to our area, particularly India, Maharashtra, on a particular date, just 1 or 2 days earlier or after. So they are very punctual. But because of climate change, this time of their visit, this time of their migration is altered a little bit. Second is the pollution. We are facing problem of pollution because of many more reasons. So soil pollution is there, water pollution is there, air pollution is there, and all these parameters, physical parameters, they play important role in the ecology. And depending on this, as the birds are dependent on many more fruits, many more seeds, many more insects, many more flowers. So if pollution, it affects adversely on soil, water and air, the qualities that birds they require to live happily in all these, that is, there are ground nesting birds, there are aquatic birds, there are aerial birds. So, it affects adversely on their distribution and on their abundance. Third important threat is the wetland loss. So, please mute all the participants. So, because of many more reasons, the wetlands are losing, and it is estimated that from our area, about 30% sites they have been serious problem with wildlife poaching, 37% affected with pollution, and many more wetlands are under grazing pressure. So all these loss of wetland, it directly affects on the distribution of wetland birds. So if any wetland is lost forever, we are going to lose that much avian diversity from our area forever. Second, wetland also get lost because of siltation, because of eutrophication. Botany and zoology peoples, they are known with the phenomenon of eutrophication of lakes. The third next threat is degradation of habitat. That means because of over exploitation of grassland, we are cutting the grass as a fodder for livestock, and because of this, the eggs, the nest of grassland birds like cursor or like GIB get exposed to its enemy, get exposed to the stray dogs or the other hunting animals which feed on the eggs and the young one of these birds. So because of degradation of habitat also, the avian diversity gets much more threatened. Next, threats due to introduced or exotic species. This is not much more problem in our area, but in Kerala and in other states, there are many more bird species, particularly ducks. The rearing and culture of ducks is known as duckery. And you will wonder to know that in Kerala, this business is highly or very well flourished business, duckery. So a farmer may have thousands of ducks, and all these ducks, they are introduced to the local wetland for feeding. So when I was in Munnar, I have seen one of the wetland thereby. So all ducks were seen, not a single bird like egret or purple moorhen, it was seen in that huge wetland. So this also threat. Then wildlife trade, many of the traders, they sell many birds like parakeets, so which is offense. So there are many birds threatened under wildlife trade. Then at the time of migration, there are many barriers. So high voltage lines, electrical lines, as we have a power station at Babaleshwar. And if you observe, or if you take an aerial photograph of Babaleshwar, then you will come to know that these power lines, they radiate in all directions. And incidences takes place that many times the huge birds like flamingos or cranes or storks, they get hit by the wires, and electroculation of birds must takes place. And the next important threat is kite festival, which we celebrate on Makar Sankranti. So because of kite festival also, number of birds every year gets injured, and many more they get die, because we do not have that much facility to treat here at present. So kite festival is also full. It is also one of man-made threat to the birds. So this is a representative picture of pollution, a representative picture of the bird trade. You can see how birds, they are sold in the market. This is again a representative picture of collision of birds with the overhead lines or with the power lines. And because of all these things, the avian diversity is threatened. Then how the avian diversity could be conserved? On government level, from government side, government has implemented Wildlife Protection Act in the year 1972 only. And because of this act, all of the organism, plant, animal, from the reserve areas are protected. And that's why you cannot take up a single grass blade or a flower from protected area. Forget about the sanctuaries, but even if the area is protected under this act, then you cannot take out a single leaf of grass, blade of grass, or even you cannot take out a very small tiny ant from the national park, sanctuary, bioreserve, wildlife heritage sites, Ramsar sites or eco parks, which are protected under this act. If you have to study, you have to make scientific study of even ants or even rhino, you have to take permission from the government, permission from the wildlife department, and then only you can go and collect few sample. But again, national parks, sanctuaries, bioreserves, wildlife heritage site, Ramsar site. We have the first Ramsar site of Maharashtra is in Andhra Madhmeshwar Bird Sanctuary, which is very close even from Shirdi, about 60 or 80 kilometers. And government also has established many eco parks to conserve the all type of biodiversity. And another important thing, as a conservation measure, as a citizen movement, government is observing Wildlife Week. This Wildlife Week we are celebrating for last 55 years, more than 55 years. This is just to promote the activity towards wildlife. And recently, just in last week, government of Maharashtra has passed the resolution that 5th to 12th November is to be observed as Pakshi Saptah all over Maharashtra. And we feel proud that as a member of Maharashtra Pakshi Mitra Sanghatna, as a member of Uttar Maharashtra Pakshi Mitra Sanghatna, we signed this application. We sent application to the government of Maharashtra that the 5th November is the birthday of Aranya Rishi Marutrao Chittampally, and the 12th November is the birthday of late Dr. Saleem Ali. Both are giants. Marutrao Chittampally has worked in the Marathi literature. He took the nature in each and every home. Whereas late Dr. Saleem Ali, who is also known as father of Indian ornithology, he wrote number of books. And he not only wrote number of books, but he studied all these birds for their ecology, for its embryology, for its behavior and all. And till date, many of us, we refer the books written by Dr. Saleem Ali Saab only. And to remember these two giants in the field of Indian ornithology, government of Maharashtra has passed resolution that this week from 5th November to 12th November is to be observed all over Maharashtra as Pakshi Saptah. Apart from this, on the conservation side, we have international conventions and agreements. We are party of all these agreements. The students from SYPSC studying environmental science, they must be known with convention as Ramsar Convention, and because of this, Nandur Madhmeshwar is declared as Ramsar site, first Ramsar site from Maharashtra. Then India is a party. We have signed this convention, the Convention on Biological Diversity, which is adopted in the year 1993. Then we have also agreed for CITES, the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna. So there is a trade of wildlife at international level. So you will wonder to know that a butterfly known as Kesariya Hind from Assam is exported to other countries. It's a very huge butterfly. Or the tortoise, they are also exported to other countries. And all this trade, it is banned because of this convention. Then the another convention known as Boon Convention, it is the Convention on the Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals. This is with respect to wild animals. We have migratory birds, we have migratory butterflies. Similarly, in African countries, wild beasts are there which migrate from one country to other country. And during migration, many of the birds, many of the animals are shot dead. So to prevent this, to regularize this, this convention is passed. Then India is also party for this convention on protection of migratory birds and their habitat.
One second, sir. 1 minute, sir. Hello, sir.
Yeah.
May I request to all audience and to all viewers to please rejoin after 2 minutes, because this is the 40-minute session is going to be expired soon. So मी सगळ्यांना विनंती करतो सगळ्या सहभागी प्रेक्षकांना की त्यांनी 2 मिनिटांनंतर लगेच जॉईन व्हायचं आहे. हे मीटिंग संपल्यानंतर त्याच लिंकवर ज्या लिंकला क्लिक करून तुम्ही आलेला आहात त्याच लिंकला क्लिक करून पुन्हा जॉईन व्हायचं आहे 2 मिनिटांनंतर. सर इफ यू फॉरवर्ड दिस रिक्वेस्ट टू फ्रॉम युअर साईड टू ऑल ऑडियन्स देन इट विल अगेन बी बेनिफिशियल.
ओके. द अनदर इंटरनॅशनल कन्व्हेन्शन इज the declaration of important bird areas. So all over the world such sites have been identified, and considering the number of birds that visits during winter or number of migratory birds visiting a particular site, number of the species observed in that particular wetland for year, the important bird areas are declared. And again, fortunately, Nandur Madhumeshwar is one of the important bird areas, Jaipadi important bird area, Dibor is also one of the important bird area, Hatnur Dam is also one of the important bird area. So in Maharashtra, there are number of important bird areas which has been declared worldwide. And the another important thing is the National Biodiversity Strategy and Action Plan. So each country develop its own national biodiversity strategies, and accordingly how to implement this strategy, it also prepares the action plan. Government of India is also having our own national biodiversity strategy, and accordingly we implement the strategy. So creation of a particular reserve forest, reserve area is the biodiversity strategy and its action. So accordingly many areas has been declared as national parks, sanctuaries. Che food geto to khol panyat jau shakat nahi karan tyache pay he atishay chote ahe tyamule tyala kayam panyacha bhovtacha jo chikhal ahe tithes tyala firava lagta. कंडेसर और उली नेक्स्ट स्टॉर किंवा आपल्या भागामध्ये याला ढोक पक्षी असं म्हणतात. दिस व्हेरी कॉमन बर्ड सीन अराउंड अवर फार्म हाऊस वस्ती या वस्तीत दिसतो. इट्स नेस्टिंग इज सीन ऑन द टॅमरिन ट्री और ऑन द फायकस ट्री. आपल्या गावाकडे चिंचेच्या झाडावरती नाल्यासारखी गर्टी दिसतात खूप मोठी, ती बऱ्याच वेळेस या पक्ष्यांची असतात. यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व इट्स व्हेरी powerful beak and long powerful limbs. The bird is also able to fly. Sampurna kalya rangachi tyachi pisa astat, and there is a metallic red patch at this place. So it's very common bird from our area, identified with the help of its fight neck, and so is called as woolly neck stork nowadays. Purvi tyala fight neck stork manache, आता त्याचं नाव बदललेलं आहे, त्याला आपण उली नेक स्टॉर्क असं म्हणतो. एस फ्लेमिंगोज, थाउजंड्स ऑफ फ्लेमिंगोज विजिट्स एव्हरी इयर टू जायकवाडी अँड भिगवन बर्ड एरियाज. जायकवाडी इज अ बर्ड सेंचुरी इटसेल्फ, भिगवन इज नॉट बर्ड सेंचुरी, बट थाउजंड्स ऑफ बर्ड्स, हाऊ 10,000, 15,000 flamingos are there every year, and you can see many more in 50,000, 60,000 at the Shevdi mud flat near Mumbai. This bird in Marathi is called as Agnipankha. Ka Agnipankha manish tyacha karan tumcha samor screen var dista, tyacha pankhanvar ha petta nikhara ghun challa kay asa dista, agni ghun challa kay dista, mhanun tyala Agnipankha. आणि इंग्रजीमध्ये फ्लेमिंगो का म्हणायचं, फ्लेम इन गो, फ्लेम म्हणजे मशाल, टॉर्च. हे उडत असताना आकाशामध्ये एखादी मशाल किंवा ज्वाला जाताना दिसते आपल्याला, म्हणतले फ्लेमिंगो असं म्हणतात. दिस इज अ लोकल मायग्रंट बिकॉज इट नेस इन लिटल रन ऑफ कच्छ अँड इन गुजरात. याची सगळ्यांची गर्टी ही गुजरात मध्ये पाहायला मिळतात. द एरिया इज नोन एज फ्लेमिंगो सिटी अँड दिस बर्ड इट मायग्रेट्स टू अवर एरिया फॉर 4-5 मंथ्स अँड इट इज सीन इन लार्ज नंबर. 4-5 महिने आपल्याकडे राहतो खूप मोठ्या संख्येत आणि इकडचं संपलं की परत त्यांच्या ओरिजिनल होम टाऊनला किंवा जे फ्लेमिंगो सिटी मी म्हणालो त्या एरियामध्ये तो जातो. नाऊ दीज आर सी गल्स. त्याच्या नावातच समुद्र आहे बट दिस फोटोग्राफ इज फ्रॉम जायकवाडी. सो व्हॉट इट टेल्स द प्रेझेन्स ऑफ सीगल्स इन ह्यूज नंबर ऍट जायकवाडी ऑर भिगवण इट अंडरलाइन्स दॅट द वॉटर क्वालिटी ऑफ दीज रिझर्वॉयर्स इज डिटोरिएटिंग डे बाय डे. ही फ्रेश वॉटर लेक्स आहेत, फ्रेश वॉटर रिझर्वॉयर्स आहेत. या पक्ष्याचं नावच आहे सीगल, समुद्र पक्षी. जर समुद्रातले पक्षी गोड्या पाण्याकडे येत असतील, समवन इज प्लेइंग विथ स्क्रीन, हॅलो मुबीन सर, मुबीन सर, हॅलो अनम्यूट युअर सेल्फ मुबीन सर.
हा यस सर, हॅलो सर.
हा समवन इज प्लेइंग विथ द स्क्रीन, देअर ओन स्क्रीन.
प्लीज मे आय रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑडियन्स, प्लीज डोंट इंटरप्ट, डोंट डिस्टर्ब विथ दिस एनोटेशन्स. I am looking into it, sir. You please continue. I am looking into it.
Yeah. So, this is not a good sign for any freshwater reservoir lake that seagulls are seen in thousands. This underlines that the freshwater quality of this reservoir is deteriorating. त्यामुळे सीगल दिसले म्हणून आपल्याला खुश होण्याचं कारण नाही. आपल्याला वाईट वाटलं पाहिजे की आपले फ्रेश वॉटर रिझर्वॉयर्स आहे हे दूषित होत चाललेले आहेत. या पाण्याचा सामो सॅलिनिटी ही वाढत चालली म्हणून हे सीगल्स.
त्या बर्डचं नाव लिहिले बरं का त्याला?
दिस इज on right hand side is open bill stork. As name indicate, its bill hi chochi ahe, hi ugdhi ahe, mhanun tyala apan ugdhya chochi cha karpocha marathi madhe, or in english
screen diste ka
open bill stork asa mhanto.
Nahi na.
Now why this bill is open? Ithe ya pakshyachi choch ugdhi disat nahi. आपण अगोदर कांडेसर पाहिलं, त्याची चोच उघडी नाही, फक्त या पक्ष्याची चोच इथे उघडी काय आहे अडकित्यासाठी?
हॅलो सर, सर
यस,
कॅन यू प्लीज रीशेअर मी स्क्रीन, पीपीटी इज नॉट सीन फ्रॉम लास्ट स्लाइड. पीपीटी, युअर पीपीटी इज नॉट अपीरिंग.
कॅन यू सी इट नाउ? हॅलो,
नॉट इट सर, नॉट इट. Reshare it. I already allowed all participants to share, but from your side I think a kind of technical problem, sir.
Okay, just
start afresh. Start from beginning, sir, then the process.
Yeah.
And may I inform you, all audience and along with today's guest, that we are having only last 10 minutes.
So we need to conclude our program because we are running out of time. So this meeting will end in 10 minutes.
The can next... I see now, sir? Hello?
No, sir. Just a second. Yes, sir. Now it is. It has started. Yes. May I request to all audience and invited guests that we need to conclude our program within 10 minutes, 9 minutes actually, because the second notification has come.
So
that meeting is going to be expired within 10 minutes.
Okay. So this is open bill store because the big, the bill ani big ekach shabd tyala choch mhanto apan hi ti ugdi aahe mhanun yala apan ugdya chochicha karkoch asa mhanto. Such a gap is not seen in this bird. So this is open bill stork and this bird in which the beak is like a spoon, this is called as spoon bill. So there is difference mhanun mi survatila sangitla ki pakshachi choch kashi aahe, शेपूट कसे आहे, त्याचे अंगावरचे पिसं कोणत्या रंगाचे आहेत ते आपल्याला बघावं लागतं. सो दिस बर्ड इज प्युअर व्हाईट, स्नो व्हाईट इन कलर अँड द बीक इज व्हेरी लॉंग लाईक अ स्पून. सो स्पून बिल, हिअर द बीक इज ओपन, सो ओपन बिल स्टॉर्क. बोथ आर रेसिडेंट बर्ड सीन इन लार्ज नंबर इन आवर एरियाज. दिस इज अ व्हेरी कॉमन बर्ड लिटल इग्रेट. आपण जनावरांच्या मागे फिरताना पाहतो त्याला आपण कॅटल इग्रेट म्हणतो. इट्स कॉमन, दिस बर्ड इज ऑल्सो कॉमन, बट देर इज लिटल डिफरन्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू कलर ऑफ द बीक. म्हणून मी मुद्दाम हा पक्षाचा फोटो दाखवतोय कारण कॅटल इग्रेट माहिती आहे आपल्याला. हिअर द कलर ऑफ बीक इज ब्लॅक, इन केस ऑफ कॅटल इग्रेट इट इज येलो. सो सच डिफरन्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू कलर, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू इट्स साईज, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू the body feathers is to be noted. This is a pond heron, again a very common bird, and the color is like that of mud. So when the bird is there in the mud sitting on any branch, it's very difficult to identify this bird. It's perfectly camouflaged. Only when the bird takes on wing, its white wings appear like this and identify the bird as a pond heron. Another important bird is called both these birds, they are called as Sharati.
It's
called as
रिजन करा सर स्पॉट ते कारण सर फ्लो मध्ये आणि सगळेजण बी 40 जण 49 म्हणजे
जो नाही किंवा चकाता शराटी बिकॉज द बर्ड इट इज स्मॉलर इन साइज अँड हॅव मेटलिक ब्लूइश ग्रीन कलर. सो इट शाइन्स इफ प्रॉपर सनलाइट इज देअर. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज ग्लॉसी आयबस. इन मराठी बोथ दिस बर्ड्स दे आर कॉल्ड एज कुदळे. आपण शेतकरी माणसं आहोत आपल्याला माहित आहे कुदळीचा उपयोग काय असतो आणि याची चोच जी आहे ती कुदळीसारखी दिसते. सो विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस बी इट टेक आउट इट्स फूड फ्रॉम द मड. ग्रे हेरॉन, नाउ इन अर्लियर स्लाइड ऑल्सो यू हॅव सीन द क्रेस्ट इज देअर to this bird and in this slide crest is there to this bird. Crest means tura. So these are the males. He nar pakshi breeding cha kala madhe nar pakshyanna ase lam shendi sarkha tura yeto jo madi madhe disun yet nahi, because in case of grey heron or in case of egrets both male and female they looks very similar. In few birds, male looks different, female look different. So this is grey heron, मराठी में त्याला पण राखी बगळा असं म्हणतो. दिस इज व्हेरी कॉमन बर्ड. दिस इज स्नॅप फ्रॉम जायकवाडी. इवन वी हॅव नेस्ट ऑफ दिस बर्ड इन आवर एरियाज. आपल्या भागामध्ये याची घरटी देखील पाहायला मिळतात. दिस अनदर कलरफुल बर्ड कॉल्ड ॲज चित्रपलक. इन इंग्लिश इट इज कॉल्ड ॲज पेंटेड स्टॉर. पेंटेड का? तर त्याला रंग दिल्यासारखं वाटतो. सो येलोइश ऑरेंज फेरी ह्यूज बिग कम्प्लीट हेड इज ऑरेंज कलर्ड देन व्हाईट कलर्ड नेक अँड द विंग्स दे आर ब्लॅक अँड व्हाईट. त्याच्या पंखांना काळी पांढरी झालर लावली काय असं वाटतं. इन द सेम वे द चेस्ट शोज द ब्लॅक अँड व्हाईट बार्स. त्याच्या छातीवर आडवे पट्टे दिसतात आणि अतिशय देखणा पक्षी आहे. वी हॅव मेनी हेरनरीज ऑफ पेंटर स्टॉर्क्स इन अहमदनगर डिस्ट्रिक्ट. अहमदनगर जिल्ह्यामध्ये पेंटर स्टॉर्कची आपल्याकडे खूप मोठी सारंगागार आहेत, म्हणजे त्यांच्या निवासाच्या जागा आहेत. अ व्हेरी कॉमन बर्ड व्हाईट ब्रेस्टेड किंगफिशर. मुद्दाम समोरचा फोटो इथे घेतलाय. इट शोज इट्स व्हाईट ब्रेस्ट. त्याला आपण खंड्या म्हणतो. शाळेमध्ये अनेकांना हा धडा अभ्यासला असेल. दिस इज वन ऑफ द मायरिटरी बर्ड मायरिटिंग फ्रॉम एशिया. व्हाईट वॅकटेल किंवा त्याला आपण पांढरा धोबी असं म्हणतो. दिस इज सीन ऑन द ग्रासलँड एज वेल एज अलॉंग द साईड ऑफ द वेटलँड. पाण्याच्या अवती भोवती किंवा अनेकदा आपल्या बागेमध्ये देखील आपल्याला पक्षी दिसतो. वी हॅव थ्री फोर टाइप्स ऑफ वॅकटेल बट दिस वॅकटेल इज कॉमनली सीन इन आवर एरिया. त्याला आपण पांढरा धोबी किंवा इंग्रजीमध्ये व्हाईट वॅकटेल असं म्हणतो. देन दिस टू, वन इज नॅशनल बर्ड ऑफ इंडिया. मोर त्याबद्दल जास्त सांगण्याची गरज नाही. दिस इज स्टेट बर्ड ऑफ इंडिया. त्याला आपण ग्रीन पिजन असं म्हणतो. येलो फुटेड ग्रीन पिजन ऑर इन मराठी इट इज कॉल्ड एज हरियल. दिस बर्ड इज ऑल्सो सीन नॉट इन गुड नंबर बट इट इज कॉमनली सीन ऑल ओव्हर द महाराष्ट्र अँड दॅट्स वाय इट इज चोजन ॲज स्ट्रेट बर्ड ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. दिस इज फ्रुगिवर्स बर्ड. दिस इज फ्रॉम द फॅमिली ऑफ पिजन. कबूतरच आहे पण आपण जी आपल्याकडे कबूतर पाहतो ती वेगळी. त्यातला हा पिवळ्या रंगाचा कबूतर आहे. त्याला महाराष्ट्राचा राज्य पक्षी हा दर्जा दिलेला आहे. सो इट्स बिहेवियर इट्स ऑल स्टाईल इज सेम टू दॅट ऑफ पिजन. रॉक पिजन जे आहे आपल्याकडे ज्याला आपण पारवा म्हणतो त्याच्याच जाती कुळीतला पक्षी आहे. त्यामुळे त्याचं सगळं वर्तवणूक त्याचं खाणं पिणं या सर्व गोष्टी त्या पक्ष्यासारखं आहे. दिस अगेन कॉमन बर्ड मार टिटवी ज्याला म्हणतो आपण. ती ही मार टिटवी माळावर राहते. तिला आपण सुवर्णमुखी टिटवी ऑर इंग्लिश इट इज कॉल्ड एज येलो वॅटल लॅपविंग. वॅटल म्हणजे मांसल काठ जी त्याच्या चोचीच्या बाजूला असते.
सर हॅलो सर वन मिनिट सर. हॅलो
येस सर.
May I make all audience a little last request to please rejoin for last 10 minutes, okay? So because this session is also going to be expired. Actually, it's been a very wonderful session is going on. That's why we are not getting that how the time is going on. And so may please rejoin, sir. You also rejoin and all audience.
I will sum up this within 2 minutes. So then you can continue with next session.
Yes, it's 1 minute is remaining only now. You take a few minutes of next session and then there will be our principal talk and then vote of thanks and all. Two things are going to be happen.
Right, yes, sir. We'll
after 1 minute, please rejoin all audience. Sagayani, 1 minute and then join over, please. Sagayana, Vinantia, Heki, 1 minute and then join over. This one,
red metal lapwing. Iche bhoti apne lal mausula gaat diste. This is very common. Seen around the water bodies, seen in the urban areas, seen in the farm houses. शेतावर दिसते आपल्याला, बांधावर दिसते, कॉलेजच्या कॅम्पस मध्ये दिसते, पाण्याच्या बाजूला दिसते. म्हणजे टिटव टिटव करून आपली झोप खराब करते ही ती टिटवी. दिस इज रेड वॅटल लॅपविंग. बट दिस येलो वॅटल लॅपविंग इज प्रिफरेबली सीन ऑन द ड्राय अरिड एरिया ज्याला आपण महारण म्हणतो. त्या महारणावरच आपल्याला ही सुवर्णमुखी टिटवी दिसते. मोस्ट ऑफ दिस बर्ड्स दे आर इन्सेक्टिव्हरस बर्ड. So on one side they are helpful to the farmers as they feed on number of pest organism like grasshoppers.
पक्ष्यांच्या प्रशिक्षणासाठी पक्ष्यांचे स्थलांतराचे कारण. आता पक्ष्यांचे पक्षामुळे पर्यावरणाचा समतोल राखला जातो, बीज प्रसार होतो, निसर्गाची सुंदरता वाढते, सकाळी सकाळी पक्ष्यांचे सुमधुर आवाजाने आपण ताजेपण. पक्षी हे शेतकऱ्यांचे मित्र आहेत. साप, बेडूक, फुलपाखरे, मधमाशा, कोंबड्या, शेळ्या असे अनेक प्राणी शेतकऱ्यांचे मित्र असतात. सर्व पक्षी शेतातील धान्य खाऊन फसतात अशी गैरसमजूत आहे. काही पक्षी शेतातील धान्य खात नसून पिकांची काढण्यात पडलेले धान्य खातात किंवा त्या ठिकाणचे किडे खातात. अशा प्रकारे हे पक्षी आपल्याला मदतच करतात, शेतकऱ्यांना पिकांचे नुकसान करतात. म्हणून अमेरिकेतील लोकांनी कॅरोल विना पॅराकिट या पोपटाच्या सुंदर प्रजातीचा वंशज संपून टाकला. माओच्या आदेशानंतर चीनी नागरिकांनी लाखो चिमण्यांची कत्तल केली. त्याचा परिणाम शेतीवर झाल्याने चीनला उपासमारीचा सामना करावा, पीक उत्पादनच न झाल्यामुळे लाखो लोक मृत्यू पडले. शेवटी चीन सरकारला रशियातून चिमण्या आयात कराव्या लागल्या व सायंकाळच्या वेळी शेतामध्ये आपल्या शेतात पक्ष्यांचे थवे बघायला मिळतात ते बघून हे मन आपलं प्रसन्न होतं. असे हे पक्षी आहे. हा असा हा पक्षी सप्ताह आहे. या पक्षी सप्ताह निमित्त या ठिकाणी उपस्थित असलेल्या सर्व विद्यार्थ्यांना, सर्व मान्यवरांना मी शुभेच्छा देतो आणि माझे दोन शब्द संपवतो. धन्यवाद.
थँक्स अ लॉट सर. ऍक्च्युअली इवन बीइंग द फॅकल्टी ऑफ फिजिक्स अँड द प्रिटी मच एंगेज्ड इन द कॉलेज ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन अँड द मॅनेजमेंट, द वे यू एक्सप्लेन्ड इन अ व्हेरी ल्युसिड मॅनर इज रिअली इनक्रेडिबल, unimaginable and unbelievable. Sir, actually we are really proud of you that you are multi-talented and multi-dimensional person, and we are enough fortunate to have you as a principal of our college because you are equally interested in our subject, means in zoology subject. Actually it is very useful for the students of our third year of zoology and second year of zoology. So sir, thanks a lot for your auspicious and informative and guideful presence once again. And really once again I would like to confess that I am really blessed and fortunate to be an anchor for the guest lecture of Dr. Kurade sir. We are really running out of time and we need to conclude us. So the last important session to express our thanks, out of thanks from my friend and my colleague, professor of the Water Department, Professor Nana Sahib Munzari sir. May I please request Nana Sahib Munzari sir, may I call upon him for expressing his vote of thanks.
Thank you, Mudin Sheikh sir.
Good afternoon
to one and all, respected and our most distinguished chief guest of the day, Dr. Sudhakar Muralidhar Kurade sir, the ardent bird watcher, researcher and naturalist, and the principal of Marathi Gule Patil College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Ahmednagar. Respected chairman of today's webinar, Principal Professor Vikas Shivgaje sir, our beloved head of Zoology Department, Professor Vikas Bhand sir, all honorable professors and my dear students. As all good things come to an end in life, this is the webinar. On behalf of Sri Sai Baba Senior College TD, myself Professor Nana Sahib Gunjal, have taken this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this webinar on the topic Birds Conservation Awareness on an occasion of National Level Bird Week organized by Science Association in collaboration with Department of Zoology. I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making this seminar such a resounding and a grand success. First of all, I would like to propose a heartly vote of thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Sudhakar Muralidhar Kurade sir, for gracing today's seminar. We get overwhelmed by your immense experience, full knowledge regarding biodiversity, its threats, strategies and plans of conservation of rare, endangered and threatened species of wildlife and birds. We have also given tremendous and helpful knowledge about your interest and expertise world of birds in a very simple language and manner. Thank you, sir, for your very interesting and thought-provoking address. And on this occasion, I assure that all the students in our college will utilize the knowledge that you have given and conserve biodiversity to lead a successful life. So we are really enlightened with your knowledge and presence.
Thank you
very much, sir.
I would like to
express my profound gratitude to our founder principal, Professor Vikas Chugajay, for his presence, enthusiastic support and immense guidance for this seminar. I am happy to express vote of thanks to our college office superintendent, respected Mr. Rajendra Kote sir, Mr. Dinesh Kanade sir, and all office staff who have made this seminar a grand success. I would like to thank our distinguished speaker and all-rounder personality of our college, Professor Mubin Sheikh sir, for making excellent presentation and making this seminar interesting and meaningful. I would also like to thank our beloved head of zoology department, Professor Vikas Bhand sir, for giving nice papers of today's program and coordination, moral support and immense guidance.
I would also like to thank
our beloved head of chemistry department, Professor Nitin Kausar sir, for giving beautiful inaugural talk of today's webinar. I am happy to express to staff members who have made this seminar a grand success. A special thanks to the organizing committee, non-teaching staff for their unflinching support and coordination. And finally, the wonderful students who have turned up in such a great number, not only from our department but also from the departments of the other departments of the college. Thank you so much for your cooperation once again, and thank all for your cordial cooperation. Thank you with these warm words and a kind message we move to the end of today's seminar. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, sir, for your fabulous vote of thanks. It's really from your bottom of the mind.
धन्यवाद सर्वांचे पुन्हा एकदा. नाईक सर काही सूचना असतील तर सांगा.
नाईक
सर
थँक्यू शिवगजे सर, मोबिल सर, थँक्यू सो मच.
येस सर, थँक्यू सो मच सर फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ. येस देव करा.
ओके
येस लिव करा, लिव करा.
Okay, so with the permission of our chief and the principal of our college, Professor Vikasji Shugaj sir, I am ending this meeting for all. Thanks a lot for all of you for your auspicious presence. Thanks a lot. Have a nice time ahead.